Hello, everybody. Smoke here for 563 Gaming, and welcome back to Darien's Tale. So, this is where his tale truly begins. Riften, home of the Thieves Guild. And we are going to go talk to Brynjolf and get things rolling.
Running a little light in the pockets, lad. Running a little light in the pockets, lad.
I'm sorry? What?
Your pockets. They're a little low on coin. I can tell.
I'm sorry, friend, but how could you possibly know that?
It's all about sizing up your mark, lad. The way they walk, what they're wearing. It's a dead giveaway.
Well, my wealth is none of your business, friend.
Oh, but that's where you're wrong, lad. Wealth is my business. Maybe you'd like a taste.
What did you have in mind?
I've got a bit of an errand to perform, but I need an extra pair of hands. And in my line of work, extra hands are well paid.
What exactly do I have to do?
Simple. I'm going to cause a distraction. You're going to steal Medesi's silver ring from a strongbox under a stab. Once you have it, I want you to place it in Branche's pocket without him noticing.
Why plant the ring on Branche?
There's someone that wants to see him put out of business permanently. That's all you need to know. Now, you tell me when you're ready, and we'll get started.
Branche. Sounds like a Dunman name.
Fresh meats and produce.
All right. I'm ready. Let's get this started.
Good. Wait until I start the distraction, then show me what you're made of.
Aye.
Everyone.
All right. Now that he's going to start the distraction,
to show you that demands your attention.
Let's get over here. This is Medesi. Let's just saddle up over here. Plenty of room.
Come on, Brynjolf. What is it this time?
Patience, Branche.
Alright. Well, really? There it is.
This is a rare opportunity.
Now, I love how the cupboard is an apprentice lock and the strong box is a novice lock. It's great. There it is. Let's go ahead and get that. I'm gonna take the gold as well.
That's what you said about the wisp essence, and it turned out to be crushed nerve root mixed with water.
Well, that was a simple misunderstanding, but this item is the real thing. Lads and lasses, I give you Valma Blood Elixir.
Oh, come on. Are you talking about the Snow Elves?
The one and only. Mystical beings who live in legends and were masters of greed.
All right, and... nope, apparel. Give.
Well, I see that my time is up.
Well, let's just mosey back on over here.
You're looking a bit under
what
the weather.
What a waste of time. Damn. I knew I shouldn't have waited.
Thank you for your concern.
Looks like I chose the right person for the job. Looks like I chose the right person for the job. And here you go.
You always repeat yourself.
Your payment. Just as I promised. The way things have been going around here, it's a relief that our plan went off without a hitch.
Without a hitch, they say. What exactly has been going on?
My organization's been having a run of bad luck. But I suppose that's just how it goes. But never mind that. You did the job, and you did it well. Best of all, there's more where that came from. If you think you can handle it.
I can handle it. Trust me, friend. I can handle it.
All right, then. Let's put that to the test. The group I represent has its home in the Ratway beneath Riften, a tavern called the Ragged Flagon. Get there in one piece, and we'll see if you've really got what it takes.
Is it true you chased a thief from your home? I overheard Aaron mentioning it.
Thieves Guild indeed.
Why take a chance?
Alright, real quick. Let's see, how much money do we have? Just 155 gold. Alright, we got nothing to really sell. We need a better dagger than the damn iron dagger, though.
What places are you talking about?
Don't play stupid. You gonna buy? See for yourself.
Yeah. Weapons. Nope.
Come back when you're ready to spend more gold.
I'm not ready to spend any gold because you ain't got crap, lady.
Come to see Balamond. What brings you to Balamond today? Repair? Purchase?
What have you got for sale?
Helmets? Pretty much anything to suit your needs.
Take it. No armor.
If you need any more smithing work, come see me again.
But no, all right. Now, I do have rock joint, I believe. Yes. So, we're going to go grab the Blessing of Mara real quick, since the temple's right here.
Blessings of Mara upon you.
Why, thank you, sir.
How may I help you, my son?
All right. Now let's head down to the Ratway. Ah, look at him being hauled off to jail. Sucker!
Looking to stay alive? Why take a chance?
Beautiful baubles and gleaming gemstones.
You look like you could use a drink. What do you say to some cheap mead?
You look like a vampire or something, dude. Go away.
Fine. It'll be 5 septims to repair it.
Why should I pay for it?
Down into the Ratway we go. Alright, I'm gonna test out Fury. Hope this works. So we can get these guys to kill each other.
I don't know, Troff. They'd skin us alive if they knew we were doing this.
Why are you always acting like such a big baby? I've gotten us this far.
This far? We're living in a sewer. They said we
Nope, doesn't work. Oh, it did work.
That's all you've got. Victory is yours. I submit.
Time to finish this.
And I need to grab flames. Oh. Yep, that hurt. Die, you son of a bitch.
No more.
I Yeah, we're not going to use bows at all. We have magic for ranged. That doesn't give us anything extra. What's this guy got? Alright, guys. So yes, this is a role, a light role play type thing where I guess, you know, I'm just giving it a shot. So, if you like the fact that I try to, like, voice the character, and if you watch the, basically the prologue episode to this, where I was kind of setting everything up for it, you know, getting spells, heading to Riften, all that sort of thing, then you'll know that, you know, I'm going to be doing everything I can to stay within character as far as the actions of the character. Now, I might be sitting here talking to you normally, but that's what makes this a light roleplay, not a full-on roleplay. Let's unlock this bad boy. I'm gonna be careful, I only got 3 lockpicks left. Nope. Ah, damn it. Too far. Got it. Alright. But yeah, so I'm just gonna be going ahead and talking to you guys like a normal let's play, but then at times when it's required, I don't want iron boots, you know, I will talk in character, make decisions based on what I think that this character would do. Like I said, he's kind of a scoundrel. I mean, he's not like a psychopath. I'm not going to kill everybody. But he's a scoundrel. You know, he's willing to pretty much do anything he wants to do. He's willing to do anything, almost anything, if there's enough coin in it. Hence us joining the Thieves Guild. And I want to give you guys some choices and some hand in this as well. Ooh. Hello, Skeeva.
Just getting this.
Oop, got a level up. Alright, so we're gonna continue to go health for now. Illusion. Anyway, like I was saying, I want to give you guys kind of some choice in the matter as well. So if we come to, like,
is
an area of the game.
Someone there? Found it. Time to finish this.
An area of the game where I feel like there's sort of a big choice ahead where, you know, we're going to do this or we can do that. I will try to leave it up to you guys. Kind of give you guys some control on what happens to our friend Dariot here. All right. Is this guy leave anything behind? No. Nothing there. Okay. Now, I'd like to do, like, a full-on role play, but quite honestly, I just don't have the time or the ability to edit as well. The simple fact that, like I said, I have this on PS4. So, lacking console commands kind of puts a lot of limitations on how you shoot these sorts of things. And to do a full-on roleplay, you get the cinematic shots and things of that nature that I would need to do, it's just really not feasible with the PS4 version. Which is why we're doing a light roleplay. There's enough demand for me to do a full-on roleplay of a different character or something. You know, if that's something that everybody really wants me to try to do, if you like my voice acting and how I try to spin the tale of Darien here, then maybe I might pick up Special Edition on the PC so I can use the console commands and do a full-on, fully edited, fully voice acted roleplay. See how close I can get to this guy.
Time to end this little game. True lords never back down.
Yeah, true lords never back down. Then you end up with a knife in your skull. Give me your money. I'll take it. And your bread. And your salt. Alright, so we've made it to the Ragged Flagon. Bouncer's not up there.
Yeah. I'm telling you.
This one is different.
Why don't you just formally join up?
We've all heard that
Quit
one before, Bryn. Quit kidding yourself.
Making a heck of a lot more
it's
coin.
Time to face the truth,
old friend. With your skills.
You, Vex,
oh, thanks for the compliment, Delvin. I may just take you up on that one day.
Things are changing.
Dying breed, eh? Well, what do you call that, then?
Stay out of trouble.
Well, well.
Gonna be
color me impressed, lad. I wasn't certain I'd ever see you again.
Getting here was easy, my friend. What else did you have in mind?
Reliable and headstrong? You're turning out to be quite the prize. So, now that I've whetted your appetite with our little scheme at the market, how about handling a few deadbeats for me?
Deadbeats? What did they do, friend?
They owe our organization some serious coin, and they've decided not to pay. I want you to explain to them the error of their ways.
Sounds good. Who are they?
Kirava, Bursi Honeyhand, and Helga. Do this right, and I can promise you a permanent place in our organization.
How exactly did you want me to handle it? Do you want them dead? We're just roughed up a bit.
Honestly, the debt is secondary here. What's more important is that you get the message across that we aren't to be ignored. A word of warning, though. I don't want any of them killed. Bad for business.
Consider it done.
Good. If you need any details on your marks, I'll be here. Now get going.
Aye. What's Helga's story?
Helga is a devout follower of Dibella and dotes over the statue to the divine that she keeps at the bunkhouse. Use it as leverage, and she'll cave.
Delvin. Almost threw two of them into the well last night.
All right.
They ate my boy.
Kirava's
stubborn, but she's got a soft spot for family. Talk to Talon Jay at the B and Bar and see if you can get something out of him. They're well acquainted, if you catch my meaning.
Indeed. And Percy?
He's as pig-headed a man as you'll ever find. The key is that ugly dwarven urn in his shop. Smash that thing to bits and he'll change his attitude.
Why can't you just settle down? Run the flagon right. With me.
I'll be here.
I don't
want to
settle. I like things the way
Stay
they are.
Stay out of trouble, or there's gonna
Come
be
on,
trouble.
Tom. Marry me.
You've already Let said that to me once, friend.
I can take care of myself.
Last person who made trouble for Vekkel ended up with a smashed head.
All right, Delvin.
Rough
what
bunch.
What gives with that case of Shadow Banish you sold me?
What do you mean? That wine tastes finer than anything Cerilli Brothers ever made.
Sure. All right. Let's go knock these out real quick.
Boots. Jewelry. If legendary they're armored, Argonian you should talk to Valamund over at the Scorched Hammer.
Porker skin.
All right. Let's go. It's the meadery. Here we are.
Drifa, I was looking through our books and there's an entry for spices. It says we spent 300 septims. What is that?
Be careful.
You're doing this. Stop!
Oh my word.
So, can I interest you in anything today? All right then. No! You're going to break it!
Just pay
Be
them,
careful.
Bercy.
If I had it, I'd pay. There's no need to do that.
This isn't happening.
I can't pay. I can't.
This isn't happening.
Now what will you do? Hmm?
No! That urn was priceless.
Yeah? Well, that was from Brynjolf. Get the message.
I can't believe you did that. You people are monsters. You demand payment for protection, and you can't even protect yourselves. Take your coin, and tell Brynjolf to leave us alone.
My thanks, sir.
Keep giving and giving, Bercy, and they'll keep taking and taking. When is it going to end?
What would you have me do, woman? Cross
Never.
The hilt? Take them all on, one by one?
All right.
What do you want?
How did you meet Karava?
I met her when I wandered into Riften a few years ago. Been smitten with her ever since. In fact, I'm thinking of asking her to marry me. In Blackmarsh, tradition dictates we present a potential mate a unique wedding ring to represent our future bond. I already have the gold band, but all I need are three flawless amethysts to complete the setting.
I can't help you there, friend.
I understand. Hopefully I'll be able to save my meager earnings up to buy them one day.
Speaking of Karava, you might want to talk some sense into her.
With the rumors going around about how poorly your guild's been doing, she's become much too bold. I'm not that foolish. The last thing I want is a war with your people.
Wise choice, friend. Help me convince her to pay.
Look, I'm only telling you this because I care for her. Don't mistake this as acceptance for what you do. Kirava has some family at a farm just inside of Morrowind. If you mention you know about it, she might just listen to you. Just please don't harm anyone. I couldn't bear the thought.
No promises, friend. But as long as she comes around, it'll be all right.
If you'll excuse me, I have other things to attend to.
Oh, Kirava.
Here for a room or... You want something or not?
I think you've had plenty, Volwolf.
Are you ready to pay Brynjolf what you owe?
No, and I never will. Now get out of my inn.
Well, maybe I should visit that farm in Morrowind.
How could you possibly know about... Please, my family means too much to me. Don't hurt them.
Then pay, and I'll forget they exist.
Very well. Here, take this back to Brynjolf and tell him he'll have no more trouble from me.
Good. One left.
You're a stranger here too, huh?
Indeed.
It's you. Please, don't hurt me.
I won't, but I have a message from Brynjolf.
I know who you are. You've been terrorizing the entire city. Please, there's no need for that here. Message understood. Here, I even have the payment.
Good.
Look, I got the message. What else did you want?
Nothing. Good day. All right.
Working
that's
at the Riften Fishery is tough.
Let's head back.
Put some coin in my pocket. I've never seen Mjoll this upset about anything. The city really gets going.
It's fun to play a bad guy. Alright, so let's head back down here and talk to Brynjolf. And don't worry guys, this isn't replacing my series on, with Strongjaw, the orc. I will still continue to do that, so you'll get both these series coming at you every single week. And before we talk to Brynjolf, if you found yourself enjoying this episode at all, then let me know by hitting that like button, and let me know what you think of my voice as far as the character voice acting goes down in the comments. And yeah,
what's going on between you and
if you want to see some more of this series, you might want to subscribe as well.
After all we've been through together, how can you do this to me?
Hey, sorry. I just get jealous when I hear...
So, job's done and you even brought the gold. Best of all, you did it clean. I like that. Dumping bodies and... Well done. And it would seem I owe you something in return. Mm. Here you go. I think you'll find these quite useful.
All right. Thank you. What's next then, Brynjolf?
Judging from how well you've handled those shopkeepers, I'd say you've done more than simply prove yourself. We need people like you in our outfit.
If there's more gold where that came from, I'm in.
That's the spirit. Larceny's in your blood. The telltale sign of a practiced thief. I think you'll do more than just fit in around here.
Before we go, I have to ask.
What's on your mind?
Word on the street is, your outfit isn't doing very well. True?
We've run into a rough patch lately, but it's nothing to be concerned about. Tell you what, you keep making us coin, and I'll worry about everything else. Fair enough?
Fair enough, friend.
Now, if there are no more questions, how about following me and I'll show you what we're all about?
Beautiful woman like you, ever see yourself with an old codger like me?
Absolutely.
Oh, really? Well then, How can we make that happen?
When you're in your grave, I'm standing over it. Now get out of my way.
Put it together.
They're a lively bunch, aren't they?
Looking for anything special.
Well, if some moon sugar should fall into your lap.
Maybe. That stuff's getting tough to bring across the border with all the old patrol.
Mercer, this is the one I was talking about. Our new recruit.
This better not be another waste of the Guild's resources, Brynjolf. Before we continue, I want to make one thing perfectly clear. You play by the rules, you walk away rich. You break the rules and you lose your share. No debates, no discussions. You do what we say, when we say. Do I make myself clear?
Crystal.
Good, then I think it's time we put your expertise to the test.
Wait a moment. You're not talking about Goldenglow, are you? Even our little Vex couldn't get in.
You claim this recruit possesses an aptitude for our line of work. Let him prove it. Goldenglow Estate is critically important to one of our largest clients. However, the owner has suddenly decided to take matters into his own hands and shut us out. He needs to be taught a lesson. Brynjolf will provide you with the details.
Mercer, aren't you forgetting something?
Since Brynjolf assures me you'll be nothing but a benefit to us, then you're in. Welcome to the Thieves Guild.
Welcome to the family, lad. I'm expecting you to make us a lot of coin, so don't disappoint me.
So how do I get my cut of the spoils?
Simple. Do as you're told and keep your blade clean. We can't turn a profit by killing. You should talk with Delvin Mallory and Vex. They know their way around this place, and they'll be able to kick some extra jobs your way. Oh, and talk to Tanelia in the flagon. She'll set you up with your new armor.
All right.
Hey, I'm not done talking to you yet. Come back here. Goldenglow Estate is a bee farm. They raise the wretched little things for honey. It's owned by some smart-mouthed wood elf named Arangoth. We need you to teach him a lesson by burning down three of the estate's hives and clearing out the safe in the main house.
What's the catch?
The catch is that you can't burn the whole place to the ground. That important client Mercer mentioned would be furious if you did.
Makes sense then.
Aye. The last thing we want to be doing is crossing our clients.
What exactly should I do about Arangoth?
Maven prefers that Arangoth remains alive, but if he tries to stop you from getting the job done, kill him. The Guild has a lot riding on this. Don't make me look foolish by mucking it up.
All right. I've got it.
You watch yourself on that island. Those mercenaries don't take prisoners.
Neither do I.
Shipment we heisted on the Cyrodiil frontier was worthless.
So you're the new recruit, huh? Well, looks like you and I are gonna have to get very well acquainted.
Should be worth a fortune.
You idiot. He said furs, not furs.
Why is that?
I'm the fence down here.
You come by anything you don't exactly own, and I'll pay you some coin for it. Minus a little slice for the guild, of course. I can also provide a few supplies useful to our trade now and again, for a small fee.
Is there anything you don't charge for?
Sure. How about I get Dirge to knock you over your head and dump you into the cistern? Look, I've been in this business a long time, and I've seen all types. You can play it tough, or you can play it smart. Whatever. At the end of the day, you'll find that all we care about down here is how much gold you can make us.
Completely understand. It's all I care about as well.
Good. Then there isn't much more to say. Here's your armor. Just make sure you put it to good use.
Thank you.
All right, then.
Alright guys, so that's going to do it for this episode. We've officially joined the Thieves Guild. Yeah. Alright, so what's in store for our guy here, Darien? We'll find out next time. As always, take it easy, have fun, later.